just take a minute and look and just see how much humanity is here. And get a sense of how many stories have come together into this room, into this weekend, into this program. Each of these faces you see has so much to say, so many stories to tell.
John Seed's definition just makes me tingle, glow inside. Ecopsychology means oikos psychi logos, knowing that Earth is home to the soul. Knowing that Earth is home to the soul. And you can see why that would have so many ramifications in this time when so much of our dominant culture seems to have forgotten this. And so our project in ecopsychology is remembering. Remembering and then applying this remembering in a strategic way to help people seat back in themselves in their deep yumminess, both as an individual and in community.
The ecopsychology program is one of the programs at Naropa that studies and aims to develop human-nature relationships, that deep, enduring, sustainable bond between humans and the natural world. Our orientation in this program includes contemplative education, a contemplative approach, as well as a transpersonal approach to ecopsychology. Both fields, transpersonal psychology and ecopsychology, recognize a deep, seamless interconnection of all of existence. With ecopsychology, the focus is on the interconnection of humans and the natural world. With transpersonal psychology, it's a broader sense of interconnection. I think we could even say that both fields recognize non-duality or a unity at their origins, at their roots. So I would say that ecopsychology is, by its nature, an inclusive approach. It's inclusive of empirical research, good, hard conceptual thinking and critical thinking, a critique of the elements of culture that have caused or gone along with a separation of humans and nature. And finally, a recognition of the deep personal bond that humans have with the natural environment.
How to strengthen environmental activism, for example. How to use what we know about psychology to be effective if people are trying to make change rather than appealing to fear or guilt or how can you drive that thing? That really does not really make me want to change if somebody comes to me that way. But what actually leads people to want to make change. I've been amazed at how deep the community becomes through the online platform. So the first thing they do is they come together and we have these intense experiential sessions for almost 2 weeks together, two courses, and they bond. Students all get to know each other, they get to know the program, they get to know us, they get to know Naropa. And then by the time they go out online, they all know each other. And then when the voices come in as written form, oh, it's like, that's that person. Oh, I'm so glad to know that's what they're thinking.
We are working to develop community among the students and community with the faculty and community with the land. In our first summer intensives, we spend time outdoors. By the second summer intensive, students are doing a week-long wilderness immersion course, essentially a rite of passage. And these students tell us after they graduate are some of the most important moments in the whole program.
Our students are amazing. These are people who recognize that the world is in crisis and they are impassioned to do something about it. They want to understand what's going on and they want to help it be better. And it's a great privilege to work with people like that.